Written by mqaqgqqgqiqeq. Julia never really enjoyed being sober. Facing reality was something she was constantly pushing off to later. She could get away with it, too, since all of her friends thought she was a blast at parties, and she gave them free drugs. Tonight, however, she had taken things too far. She was in the bathroom with a few people snorting cocaine, when all of a sudden she felt as if her heart was about to jump out of her body. Her eyes darted around the room, but she found herself unable to open her mouth. Julia moved to leave, but when she reached for the door, she collapsed on the floor. She opened her eyes to find herself in an empty, white-walled room with no windows or doors. "Am I in a mental hospital or something?" she thought to herself, rubbing her eyes in an attempt to wipe away wherever she was. She swiveled around to see an option bar and a timer behind her. "You can now play as a cat. You may verbally accept or decline. If the timer reaches zero, your decision will be an automatic decline. Remaining time to decide? 34 minutes and 42 seconds. "Play as a cat? Play what?" Julia screamed out. "Hello? Can anybody hear me? Who the fuck has me locked up like this? I swear to God, this is not nearly as funny as you think it is." No response. "Seriously, okay, I won't be mad. Just let me out. Please?" Still no response. All of a sudden, it dawned on her. She remembered everything. "Wait a minute, am I dead?" she thought to herself. "Damn, I wish I could see people mourning me." She glanced at the timer to see that at this point, she had a little less than 30 minutes to make a decision on whether or not to play as a cat. Julia reflected on her own life for almost 20 minutes. She thought deeply about who she had become and ultimately realized that she wanted to destroy her human self. "I accept!" she yelled to the option bar in front of her. Moments passed, and she woke up again, this time in her parents' living room, perched on a cat bed. "Wait a second, am I my parents' cat? What happened to Butters?" Before she could think too hard about where Butters' soul had transferred to, Julia's mom, Heather, walked in and sat on the couch. She was on the phone with an old friend. "Heard what about Julia? I mean, nothing at this point could possibly surprise me. She's completely out of control. I don't even know what to do at this point. I've told her she needs to get her act together countless times, but she doesn't listen. I swear, the only thing that will end this is her ending up either dead or in jail." "Anyways, what did you hear?" Julia internally rolled her eyes at her mother's assessment. It was nothing she hadn't heard before, but it still stung a little. Especially now that she was actually dead, proving her mother right. "Wait, what?" Heather's tone completely changed from ridiculing to heartbroken. "No, I had no idea. Okay. Thank you. I need to call Stephen. Yes, I'll let you know if I need anything." Heather hung up the phone and stared at the wall in front of her. She found herself unable to cry. All she could think about was how she failed her only child and where she had gone wrong as a mother. Julia had never seen her mother like this, and she suddenly felt compelled to comfort her mother. She got up from her soft, pillowy bed and walked over to her mom. She jumped onto the couch and delicately placed a paw on her mother's lap, looking up into Heather's eyes. At this point, her mom burst out into tears and pulled Julia as close to her as possible. At this moment, Julia let go of any and all resentment she had towards her mother. Watching her mom break down was the single worst pain Julia had ever felt. She could not help but feel guilty for putting her mom through the death of her only child. After all, it was her choice to push the limits the night of her death. But she felt that she finally had a purpose in life. To be the greatest source of comfort for her mother that she could possibly be after a lifetime of disappointing her. This mother-pet relationship would be new to Julia, but one that she would come to appreciate. She was finally able to be emotionally close with her mother, and there were no expectations to be a certain way for either of them. They simply enjoyed each other's company.